Sometimes there are so many things which makes us to turn back and not follow up with our commitment. Speak to us this morning, O God. And we pray this in the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. Let us take our seats. Today, the title of our sermon will be The Challenge of Commitment. The Challenge of Commitment. We have seen from the first scripture readings how Elisha was able to follow through the commitment he made to Elijah until he saw him being taken up to heaven. We have the same image. But for us, we are not following Elijah or Elisha or for the call, but we are following Jesus. That's why we sang, I have decided to follow Jesus. Not turning back. I wish it was that easy. We'll be singing it every day. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. Not turning back. That is the desire of every Christian. Jesus without turning back. So who is Jesus to us? Who is Jesus? Jesus, in the earthly terms, is the commander-in-chief of the army forces. We are the forces of Christ, and Christ is our commander-in-chief. So that means we cannot do anything without following the orders. That means we are a community under orders. We are a community that does not do its will, but we are a community that follows orders from above. But most of the times, we turn back. We have sung, not turning back. But most of the times, because we are soldiers in the Christian army, but we also have an enemy, who is the devil. And the enemy tries to discourage us. The enemy tries to tell us what we are doing is in vain. The enemy tries to convince us that Jesus will not deliver on his promises. Some of us have been trapped. We have fallen back. Just like the wife of Lot, she turned back. Most of the times, we have turned back too. We know people who have been very, very strong religious leaders, people of faith. At some point, they turned back. So, it is possible to turn back. It is possible to be sidetracked. So, this morning, as we see the scriptures, let us see Jesus first in this scripture. Jesus, the Bible says, his face was focused on Jerusalem. Jesus was going to die for us. And Jesus, at the moment, he was not thinking about now. He was focused on where he was going. Jesus knew he was going to Jerusalem, but he will never come out alive. He knew he was going there to do the ultimate sacrifice, to die for you and for me. But before he did that, he said some disciples to go into a village. And this village was owned by the Samaritans because he wanted something to be prepared. When they came in, the Samaritans rejected. Why did they reject this? Because when they saw Jesus, they knew Jesus' face was focused in Jerusalem. What does that mean? Any good Jew had nothing good to say about Samaritans. Samaritans were like half-castes. Jesus said, for a space in them, they said, now, this man has no interest here. He is focused to go to Jerusalem. Then the disciples, John and James, that's what the Bible says, they had the powers to do punishment. And they asked Jesus, do you want us to call fire from heaven and punish the whole village? Do you want us to burn them down because they never received you? I wish I knew what Jesus told them. But the Bible says, Jesus rebuked them. Jesus did some talk to them. Jesus called them aside and saying, our kingdom is not the way you live. We do not live in the times of judgment. We are in the times of God's mercy and grace. That is what Jesus is telling them. Whoever does not receive me, this is not the time for judgment. This is the time for another chance. This is the time for salvation. Do not kill them. Do not punish them. The disciples could not understand how that was possible. To them, it was instant punishment. Then somebody asked Jesus, I want to follow you, Jesus. I have decided to follow you. I have decided to follow you. Then Jesus told the person, I have decided to follow you. But Jesus told him it was not that easy. Let us go. The man gave some excuses. Do we see that in the scriptures? Those three men, they all wanted to follow Jesus. But none of them was willing to commit to what it takes to be a follower of Jesus Christ. None of them wanted to commit. It takes commitment to become a follower of Jesus. Back in the day, and even today, nothing has changed. Jesus is telling us, because one man saying, I want to follow you, but let me go back home and buy my dad. Buy my dad. So Jesus tells them, let the dead bury their dead. Then he says, no one, having put his head to the plow and looked back, is ever more as fit for the kingdom of God. Jesus is telling us the seriousness of this commitment. That you cannot put your hands to follow Jesus, then you keep looking back. Nobody does that who is fit for the kingdom. Today in our lives, we have the Samaritans, those people who do not receive us. Those people who do not even want to hear about the vision you have for the kingdom. The Samaritans never received Jesus and the disciples. Most of the time, we want to evade that your job to have people who will never receive you. Who will never recognize you as who you are. Yesterday during the yard sale, you know, it was a teachable moment. Some people were coming in their vehicles. As soon as they saw who was doing the yard sale, they just turned about and drove off. You know, some people are able to come in, those who do not mind, they have integrated them well with the system. That could teach us. Some people do not have a heart to welcome. So when Samaritans show up in your life, how do you react? Do you go punishing everybody who has not accepted you? Do you go punishing everybody who speaks bad about you? What do you do? Most of the time, you want to rebel like James and John. You want to call fire from heaven and come and destroy the people who do not receive us or the word of God. But that is not the Jesus we serve. That is not the Jesus we must follow. That is not the Jesus we are seeking, we have decided to follow. But when we turn back, we have a land pocket with the Father. the beauty of the moment we are living in. We are living in the times of the mercy of God. We are living in the times of salvation. But a moment will come when it will be judgment. And when judgment comes, we will survive if we follow through with the commitment we made. So as we continue with this week, as we continue to enjoy our summer, have we completely decided to follow Jesus? How good are we with the small commitments we make with each other? Do we follow them through? Has someone committed something to you but they don't follow through? Maybe in the family. Maybe your friend. Do we follow through with our commitments with each other? If not, we still have a chance. But if we do a job looking back, whether it's a kingdom job or where we are hired, we will have nobody to pray. I try to do my job to the best of my knowledge. Try to do yours to the best of your wisdom. If you have an 8-hour job, 3 to 11, make sure you are there 3 to 11. That is the commitment. If we are baptized, we committed to resist the devil, make sure you are doing 24/7 job of resisting the devil. Because the devil has not got to sleep. Sometimes our shift will come to an end. 11 o'clock you broke out. Some other people broke in at 11. 7 a.m. you broke in. But you are not working 24 hours. But the devil, our enemy, is working 24/7. The devil does not take a day off. The devil works all the shift. And the devil will make sure we will not follow Jesus. But we have and we serve a mighty God who will never forsake us nor leave us alone. But let us not underestimate the devil. He will always tell us there is something important to God we finish before we can come to serve our God. He will always tell us it's that deal. Finally, Jesus told us to love him. Jesus told us to love him and to follow him. As you do your job, let us all remember we are temporary in this world. We are passing by. Soon and very soon, we will go to our final home. And I do not want to be called to be asked what happened when you were in Trinity. Did you invite everybody? Not to be so comfortable. That's why we are singing, we have decided to follow Jesus. Do everything else you do, but don't forget to follow who? Follow Jesus. I know you follow some people online. Whatever you get after following them, I don't know. But I tell you, after following Jesus, you're going to get eternal life. That's all I can promise. Some people will unfriend you after seeing you are not beneficial. You know, I don't even love you. That happens all over the world. Jesus is the only one who will never... Yes. In the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit, I am the Son.